Hello students, let's move for the fourth sum in the exercise 11. In the exercise 11.1, fourth sum. So given that 15 cot A equal to 8, find sin A and secant A. That has given. Let's write one right angle triangle. So that is A, B and C. Right angle dot B and angle dot A. Okay, right angle dot B, then angle, trigonometric angle at A, because A has given, for that sake. So 15 cot A equals 8. 15 cot A equals 8. This is a given. What happened for cot A? Cot A equals nothing but 8 divided by 15. Like that we can take. So we know the ratio of cot A. Cot is the opposite of tan. Tan ratio is opposite divided by A. I mean adjacent, that nothing but cot A, that opposite, I mean that reciprocal, adjacent divided by opposite. Tan is the cot is the reciprocal of tan. Okay, tan is opposite divided by adjacent, cot its reciprocal, that nothing but the adjacent divided by opposite. So which is opposite to that angle A? This is an opposite and this is hypotenuse and this is adjacent. We know that, right? Write the value. Adjacent is nothing but it is a 8 and opposite is 15. So we want to find hypotenuse. Hypotenuse, we know about that, how to solve that according to, because it is a right angle triangle, so can take according to Pythagoras theorem. PT means not prove that, it is Pythagoras theorem here. So according to Pythagoras theorem, we can write AC square equals AB square plus BC square. Let us substitute the value. AB is nothing but 8 square plus BC is 15 square. Okay, so 8 8s are 64, everyone knows that, plus 15 square means 15 15s are, it is 225. So totally finally 225 plus 64, we got the 289. So this is the value of AC square. So we know the square number for 289. So we can write this 289 as 17 square. Square square get cancelled. AC equals 17 centimeter. So here hypotenuse we got, that is the 17. So next they are asked us to find out sin A and secant A. Let us take sin A first. Sin A in the ratios, you know, that is the opposite divided by hypotenuse. Opposite is 15 and hypotenuse we found out already, that is 17. So this is the value of sin A. Next we have to take secant A. Secant is the opposite of cos, I mean reciprocal of cos actually. So cos, everybody know cos ratio, that is the adjacent divided by hypotenuse, that reciprocal, that nothing but the hypotenuse divided by adjacent. So students, you have to learn that ratio, then it is easy to solve you. So secant, that is adjacent divided by hypotenuse divided by adjacent. Hypotenuse we got 17 and the adjacent, that is the 8. So this is the sin A value 15 by 17, and secant A value is 17 by 8. These are all easy sums. Okay, you can solve, but trigonometric ratios are very important to solve. Hope you will understand the fourth one. So let us move for the fifth one. So this is the fifth one. Given that secant theta 13 by 12, calculate all the other trigonometric ratios. They are asked us to find out all the other trigonometric ratios. Let us write the rough right angle triangle. So secant theta A, B, C. Here this angle that has given us theta, so take that as a theta, or you can take this also anyhow. So if you have taken this as a theta, that opposite is a opposite and this is a hypotenuse obviously, and this is adjacent side. Okay, so secant theta that has given, secant theta is 13 by 12. So you know the ratio of secant theta. Secant is a, now only I taught you, secant theta, theta is the reciprocal of cos theta. So cos theta, that is nothing but the adjacent divided by hypotenuse. So secant theta is its reciprocal, I mean hypotenuse divided by adjacent. Okay, so up to tan theta, if you learn the ratio, then we can take that reciprocal. Okay, hypotenuse is hypotenuse in the sense that is a 13, they only has given. So here we have equaled already, hypotenuse is 13 and adjacent is 12. Okay, so let's take hypotenuse is 13 and adjacent is 12. So the remaining, according to Pythagoras theorem, according PT means Pythagoras theorem, we know that AC square equals AB square plus BC square. Okay, so AC square in the sense 13 square and AB is 12 square plus BC square, we don't know, right as it is. So what happened for BC square? 13 13 is 169 minus 12 4 means 144. We did already like this sum, 169 minus 144 is nothing but it is a 25, right? Okay, so we can take BC square. So 25 square number, that is a 5 square, square square get cancelled. BC equals 5 centimeter. So this thing we got here, 5. Okay, BC is 5. So now we can write other ratios. Yes, because we got one side. So let's start from sine theta. So sine theta, everybody knows the sine theta ratio, that is the opposite divided by hypotenuse. Opposite nothing but here 5 and the hypotenuse is 13. So 5 by 13 is the sine theta. Its reciprocal we can write here, that is sine theta reciprocal, always it is a cosecant theta. So we can write directly this cosecant theta reciprocal. So that nothing but hypotenuse divided by opposite. Okay, here only if you are writing, it is very easy for us. So that reciprocal is 13 by 5. So this is the cosecant theta reciprocal, right? Cosecant theta value. Next, sine after, we know that is the cos theta. Cos theta trigonometric ratios, now only I told you, that's opposite. Or here only we can write for this cos theta. Cos theta equal to, cos theta is the reciprocal of secant theta, no? So adjacent divided by hypotenuse, that nothing but 12 divided by 13. So here only, in this only we can write here. So next, sine cos over, next is tan theta. Tan theta, that ratio of tangent theta, that is opposite divided by adjacent. Opposite is 5 and adjacent is 12. So this is the tan theta. So if you are taking this reciprocal, we will get the cot theta. Cot theta is its reciprocal, nothing but 12 by 5. So if you are writing like that only, by taking that reciprocal, then it is easy for you, not required more step to do that. Okay, so hope you will understand. So all the thetas we wrote, that is 6 trigonometric ratios: secant theta, cos theta, sine theta, cosecant theta, tan theta and cot theta. So hope you will understand this. Okay, hope you will understand this. So next we have to move for the next one, that is the sixth sum. It is, if angle A and angle B are the acute angles such that cos A equal to cos B, show that angle A equal to angle B. So let us take one rough diagram for this, for the ABC, angle A and B and C, ABC this is, okay. Angle A and angle B, they has taken as acute, no? So better write this as B and this C, because both are acute. Acute in the sense, not right angle. So angle C will be 90 degree. Angle A and angle B is acute angles as per a given. Okay, we know that this is also acute and this is also acute. Acute in the sense, less than 90 degree. such that cos A, so if you have taken this as an angle, I mean A as an angle, so this has become a opposite, right? And this is always a hypotenuse and this is a adjacent. So for this, the cos A is, what happened for this, the cos A in the sense, cos A ratio, you know already, that is cos A ratio always will be adjacent divided by hypotenuse. The adjacent here we can get the AC and the hypotenuse is AB. Take this as a 1. Cos A value is AC divided by AB. So in the same way, we want to find out the cos B by taking B as an angle. Okay, A and B here also both are acute angle and C is a 90 degree. But your angle should be taken as B. Here A and here B. So that opposite, this is a opposite. Always it is a hypotenuse. Now adjacent it is. So here cos B value, this is a cos A and this is a cos B. The ratio is same, that is adjacent divided by hypotenuse. Here adjacent is BC, we can see here, and hypotenuse is AB. So BC divided by AB. Take this as a 2. Okay. And so they've only told, we know that already, we know that in a triangle, angle of opposite sides are equal. In triangle, angles of opposite sides, this is one condition, or equal. We know already in 8th and 9th everywhere. Okay, what is that? We know that in a triangle, angle of opposite side. So which is the angle of opposite side here? This is angle B and for this angle A. Okay, angle of opposite sides are equal. So therefore, we can write here what angle A equal to angle B, because angle A is the opposite side for this and angle B is the opposite side for this. Okay, so we can write as angle A equal to angle B. Hope you will understand. And here also we can get cos A equal to cos B only, because AB will cancel and AC equal to BC we will get. Opposite sides, AC and BC are the opposite sides here, right? Okay, hope you will understand the sixth one. Now let's move for the seventh sum. So this is the seventh sum. So let's read the sum first. If cot theta equals 7 by 8, evaluate 1 plus sin theta into 1 minus sin theta divided by 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. So let us write the rough right angle triangle for this also, that is A, B and C. So this is cot theta, theta as taken as A, angle A as taken as theta here, and this opposite, it is an opposite, and this is always a hypotenuse and this is a adjacent. So that has given cot theta. Cot theta in the sense 7 by we know that what is the ratio of for cot theta. Cot theta is the reciprocal of tan theta, right? So tan theta is opposite divided by adjacent. That means cot theta is adjacent divided by opposite. Always it is the adjacent divided by opposite, that is the cot theta. Adjacent in the sense, this is the value has given 7 by 8, because that has given adjacent in the sense it is a 7 and opposite is 8. So according to Pythagoras theorem, according to PT means Pythagoras theorem, so the value of AC square equals AB square plus BC square. Let us substitute AB is 7 square plus BC is 8 square. 7 sevens are 49 plus 8 eights are 64 we got here. So 84 49 plus 64, we got here 49 plus 64 is 9 plus 4 is 13, 1 carry, 4 plus 6 is 10, 113. So this is a AC square. Even this 113 is also not having a perfect square number. So we can write AC is square root of 113. So this is square root. If it is not having a perfect square number, you can take a square root. Okay, if it is having a perfect square, then you can solve further. So this is the value of AC, that is the root 13. So let us take this as given. In the first one, we want to find out the sine theta and the cos theta. The value of sine theta is, here only we have to find out, then it is easy to do the sum. The value of sine theta ratio, we know that is the opposite divided by hypotenuse, nothing but the opposite is 8 and hypotenuse is root 113. This is the value of sine theta, and we require the cos theta also. Cos theta value, cos theta ratio, always it is, you have to learn the ratio students, adjacent divided by hypotenuse. Adjacent is 7 and the hypotenuse is also 1, root 113. Let us take the first one. Okay, so which is that 1 plus sine theta into 1 minus sine theta divided by 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. So I think you know about that, it is in the form of a plus b into a minus b. According to a plus b into a minus b, we know the formula of a plus b into a minus b, that is a square minus b square. So here, according to this, a we should take as 1 and b we should take as sine theta. So if a square, in the sense 1 square minus sine square theta. So in the same way, even in down also, here a in the sense 1 square minus b square in the sense cos square theta, because both are in the form of a plus b into a minus b. So 1 square minus sine square theta in the sense 1 square in the sense 1 only minus, let us substitute the value of sine theta. Sine theta is 8 by root 113. So there will be the square, you should put the square for that. So divided by 1 square means 1 minus cos theta is 7 by root 113 whole square. Okay, yes, 1 minus, if you are separating 8 square in the sense 8 8s are 64, divided by square and square root get cancelled, remaining only 113 here. And down in a denominator, 1 minus 7 square in the sense 7 7s are 49, and square and square root is also get cancelled here, that is 1 minus 113. 1 minus 49 divided by 113. So if you have taken a 113 LCM in the numerator, we got 113 minus 64 divided by, if you have taken a 113 here LCM, so that will be 113 minus 49. So here if you have taken a reciprocal of this also, 113 will get cancelled. In a numerator, 113 minus 64 is 113 minus 64 is 49 divided by 113 minus 49 is 64. So this is the value of this 1 plus sine theta into 1 minus sine theta divided by 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. Let's find out the second one. In this, the second one is, we want to find out the cot square theta. So cot theta, they only has given the value, not necessary to find out, that is the 7 by 8 here only has given. Cot square theta in the sense 7 by 8 whole square. Okay, if there is a square, we want to put square. 7 square in the sense 7 7s are 49, and 8 square means 8 8s are 64. Even this also is having the same value on cot square theta is also basically same value. If they ask us info the prove that equal to cot square theta, yes, it is proved. This is a LHS and this is a RHS. We can prove like that. Okay. Hope you will understand this. The next sum we have to do in the next period. Thank you all.